Heritage Trust presents the Land Heritage Award to an individual, organization, agency, or coalition that has made outstanding contributions to land conservation in Maine while inspiring others. In 2008, the award was renamed and endowed in honor of Maine Coast Heritage Trust's longtime president, Jay Espy. In doing so, Maine's board sought to celebrate Jay's vision and leadership for land conservation and his spirit of collaboration. The selection considerations are the nominee's history and body of conservation work, including specific recent accomplishments, the relevancy of that work to current issues, and the lasting impact of the work, the extent to which the recipient of the award by nominee will inspire, influence, or otherwise advance land conservation efforts in Maine. As always, there was an impressive pool of nominations, any one of which would have been a deserving and inspiring choice for this award. But this year, there was one nominee that stood out because of the way they support their community, the way the community supports them in return, and the thorough, professional, and long-term view they take of their stewardship responsibilities. And they've conserved a heck of a lot of land. This organization believes that the conservation of the natural resources in their part of Maine is inextricably linked to the economic health of the community. They strive to conserve wildlife habitat, enable jobs through sustainable harvesting of community forests, provide public access to recreation areas, and more. They've been remarkably successful. In some areas, they have conserved working forest lands and thus helped preserve the jobs that go with that industry. There are conserved, unspoiled lake and river shorelines that support a critical recreation economy, school programs, access for hunters, ecological preserves, boat launches, trails, campsites, and more are all part of the mix. In short, this organization has woven together different lands management practices and conservation techniques to conserve a landscape that meets many goals and garners overwhelming community support. This community support takes many forms. They have engaged an active and engaged and committed board, a similar volunteer network. They are supported by groups as varied as the local pulp mill, fishing guides, and the Passamaquoddy tribe. And at a recent town meeting, the community voted unanimously to donate $40,000 of the taxpayers' money, this from a small town in Washington County, for one of the land trust's projects. Their long-term view of stewardship is impressive. Their lands that are in forest management have a long-term plan that creates habitat for a wide range of plants and animals through a focused species approach. They manage an ecological reserve, a late successional forest management area, and more. This organization has received forest management certification from the Forest Stewardship Council through the Smart Wood Program of the Rainforest Alliance. They partner with neighbors to improve habitats across ownership boundaries. While we probably talk about bucks and acres too often, it's hard not to be impressed with some of the numbers. They began by protecting a 27,000-acre property to create a community forest. This purchase included 62 miles of lake shore, essential to maintaining the character and water quality necessary to maintain the region's guiding economy. As the local partner of a New England-wide coalition, they were instrumental in the acquisition of 312,000-acre easement on working forest lands and a 50-mile river corridor. Before they'd finished these projects and raised a cool $35 million, an important 6,000-acre parcel came on the market and was at risk. Only $3.2 million. How could they resist? It's true that they have some great national and regional partners. They contract with local experts to help with their stewardship needs, and they have an active and committed board. But did I mention that this organization has a staff of two? Lest you think that this organization is resting on their laurels, after these great accomplishments in their first 10 years, consider this. They currently have an option to purchase a 21,000-acre property, which is a critical parcel in creating a 1.4 million acre international wildlife corridor. The good news is that this project ranked number one in the entire country for the U.S. Forest Service Forest Legacy Program for 2011. The bad news is that they have to raise $24 million to complete the purchase. It won't be easy. It's obviously not a slam dunk, and there is risk. But their willingness to take risks, to pursue their expansive conservation vision in support of their community, is part of what has led to their success to date. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very pleased to award the 2011 SB Land Heritage Award to the Down East Lakes Land Trust. Their vision, support for the community, and stewardship are a model for us all. As part of this award, the Down East Lakes Land Trust is entitled to direct $5,000 to the land conservation project or organization of their choice. And they've informed us that these funds will go to their West Grand Lake Community Forest project. Please join me in congratulating Mark Berry and the Down East Lakes Land Trust.